Come on, wave your hands and shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you love Jesus this morning, wave your hands and shout louder hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Give your neighbor a high five. Tell your neighbor, 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 I'm convinced today that my blessing will be bigger than yours. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, if there is any man God will bless, me number one, you number 49. Give the Lord a clap and a shout. Amen and amen. I want to salute Reverend Fedner and his wife. I love them sincerely and dearly from my heart. It's been years that we connected, and there was a need for me to come. But somehow, there's always a restraint. Either a meeting collide with another one and I won't make it, or at the time I am ready, you just finished a meeting. So I really released myself and relaxed until this weekend, when it was clear that I was going to the nation of Pakistan for a crusade of 300 to 500,000 people. So I put a call through to him. I said, at least let me stop on a Friday, probably Saturday morning, since my crusade will be on Saturday night and Sunday night. He said, with all pleasure. And that is why I'm here today. Give the Lord a clap off. You know, the Bible said Jesus need to go through Samaria. I came for somebody. I didn't come for everybody. And that person will know 15 minutes from now. You just need 15 minutes to know whether this man of God came for you or not. I didn't come for everybody. But if you are the one I came from, shout me number one.
Me number one.
Amen. I love you so much for doing ministry in a harsh environment, condition, environment that is not favorable. I salute every one of you doing ministry here, Dubai, Qatar, Indonesia, Pakistan, India, and all of these places. We love you guys so much, and we're praying for you. Even though our own country has become hostile too. And you know, I come from a place, I'm from the northern side of Nigeria, from Borno State, Maiduguri. I came from the home of Boko Haram, so I know the assault. I'm a spiritual Boko Haram, so I can deal with every devil. Somebody shout amen. But 70% of my members, whether in Jos or in Abuja, are all Igbos. Then South follow. And I just knew that God called me to the Southeast and the South effectively. And I'm glad to be here today. I came with my wife. She's so tired. She's been working. I asked her to rest. Tomorrow she'll be with us 10 a.m. Amen. I love you all. I also came with, I've written over 30 books. I came with just 10 different copies. And I came with three copies each, which means 30 copies. This is first serve, first. And this is 30 years of experience I put in this book. I've been preaching now for about 30 years. Very loaded and brutal. These books can change even the color of your skin. If you read any of this book, you'll be transmogrified. This one is called Greatness, God's Agenda. This is turning adversity into breakthrough. Papa Yoroshija, forward this. This is revival for survivor. This is take it all principles. This is battle for rest. And this is glory, unveiling the glory. This is the greatest outpour of God's spirit saved for the last day. This book is titled Destiny. This one is Dynamics for Fruitfulness. This one is Provoking Supernatural Breakthroughs. All of these books, they are loaded, they are anointed. It's 70 dirhams. Pick it. Everywhere I go around the world, I sell it $20 to $30 everywhere. So you just pick one of this book. I assure you, you will never recover for time and eternity. There are just not many. So make sure you lay hands on this book. Sleep with it. Wake up with it. Don't recharge your phone until you charge your life with these messages. I'm telling you, by the time you charge yourself, even you, you'll be glad you did. Somebody say, I hear you. Shout it louder. Are you ready for today? Lift up your hand, say, my Father, my Father. I will not let you go unless you bless me. Open your mouth and pray that prayer. I will not let you go unless you bless me. Mighty, mighty God, worship you today. Give him all the praise as we lift our hands to you. Treasures in our heart, lift our voice and say, everything written about you is great. You are great, yes, you are. Shout that amen like a thunder. Amen. You may be seated. God bless you. Provoking supernatural access is what we are looking at. Access is man's greatest battle. The battle a man will ever fight is at the gate of his access. Life is about access. The battle of Israel from Egypt to the promised land was a battle for access. The insistence for Moses to ask Pharaoh to let the people go was because they wanted access. No matter your giftings, no matter your talent, no matter your loadedness, if you lack access, you'll be wasted. Beauty remains useless when there's no access. Your catwalking is a waste without access. Your connection is at the mercy of the access of your life. And I'm not just talking about access, but I'm talking about supernatural access. What is supernatural access? Number one, supernatural access is the empowerment to enter into a place unrestricted. It is the empowerment to enter into a place unhindered. Hear me, nobody was allowed to see the king except the king's stretch and scepter. But Esther entered without invitation. She broke protocols and relegated laws, and the king stretched his scepter, and Esther had access. There are many of you have been in this nation. From your eyes, I can see that you were not born here. Most of you just came to settle down and to prosper. If there's anything you are believing God for, is access. I declare from today, may God give you access to the glory of this land. Access to the blessing of this land. Access to the wealth of this land. Access to the favors of this land. Access to the monies of this land. Access to the business of this land. From today, God will give you unusual access. Lift up your hand, shout access. Protocols can be relegated where access is given. So the king stretched his scepter and Esther entered. I declare from today, somebody is about to enter some realms because of access. Some monies will enter your life because of access. Some level of breakthroughs will enter your life because of access. Lift up your hand, shout access. Number two, what is access? Access is the termination of stagnation and the commencement of transformation. Somebody say the termination of stagnation and the commencement of transformation. Can I declare to somebody, by the power of access, you are moving from a write-off to a point of reference. From a nobody to a somebody. From a non-entity to some entity. From coincident to God's incident. From rejection to projection. From shamification to glorification. Where they say no to you, after now they shall say yes. Somebody will get job without interview. Somebody will be lifted without protocols. What took people 50 years to get, God will give you in 5 months. Lift up your hands and shout access. Sir, access is the unveiling of kingdom inheritance. Number three, is the unveiling of kingdom inheritance beyond human reach. Is the unveiling of kingdom inheritance beyond human reach. Child of God, I have discovered there are things God has given to you. It takes your eyes to open to see them. Listen, it has to be unveiled. If not, you can't receive them. Hear me, child of God. The things of the kingdom are buried in mysteries. The things of the kingdom are covered in mysteries. It takes the unveiling for you to assess it. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? Long before Haggai was crying for water, there was a well in the wilderness. Long before Haggai began the journey in the wilderness of Shur in Genesis 21, there was a well waiting for her. Long before she had thirst and her son thirsted for water, there was a well. But it took the opening of her eyes to discover that there can be a well in the desert. Hear me and hear me well. There is message in your mess. There is money in your shame. There is treasure in your trash. There is glory in your glory. Hear me, where it is not working, something can still work. All you need is the opening of your eyes. You'll be praying for husband, meanwhile your husband is by your side until your eyes open. You'll be praying for breakthrough, meanwhile breakthrough is by your side until your eyes open. Rock of ages, open my eyes. I prophesy the monies you need to see, the opportunities you need to assess, I command your eyes to open. There is a well in this land. There is a breakthrough for you in this land. May your eyes be open. 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 Somebody shall access. It takes the unveiling for you to be seen. Even to be a preacher, you need access to light. Paul said that the eyes of your understanding may be enlightened. Paul said that God will give you unto me the door of utterance. Access into utterance, into revelation. So you can be a preacher and be wasted until you have access to light. Until you are given ability to consume mysteries. You cannot indict a good matter. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying here? So the eloquence of a preacher, the depths of his revelation is at the mercy of the access of his life. Am I talking to somebody here? You need more than catwalk to marry. You need more than beauty to marry. You can have all of these giftings and still be wasted without doors of marriage open for you. Your intelligence is a waste until the door of opportunity open for you. And I return and I saw under the sun that the race is not won by the fastest man. Battles are not won by strong men. Riches are not for those that went to school. It is not of him that willeth, neither of him that runneth. It is of the Lord that showeth mercy. Somebody shall access. Take your seat. Somebody shall access. Can I prophesy to somebody here? After today, God will give you mega access. You will walk with great people. Access to those that matter. Access to the people of the land. Access to the government of the land. Access to the business of the land. Some of you are shifting from side kind of business, useless kind of business, to financial buoyant businesses. I connect you by fire. I connect you by fire. I connect you by fire. Lift your legs. Shout access. Take your seat. Number four. Access is the breaking of satanic resistance in the pursuit of physical and spiritual substances. It is the breaking of satanic resistance in the pursuit of physical and spiritual substances. I discover certain assets require force. There are some assets you need to break something. Access is not only to enter, access is also to exit. Hear me. Access is not only for entering, it's also for exit. I have heard the cry of my people in Egypt, and I've come down to deliver them. My friend, that is access. Access out of Egypt. There are some of you, you need to come out of some condition, some financial battles. Some of you need to come out of suffering. It's not only to enter something, you must come out of something. I don't know if I'm talking. Anywhere you are, you don't like, I command you, come out of it. Any condition you are that you don't like, I command you, come out of it. I say, come out of it. You will not die in that problem. You will not die in that battle. That situation will not kill you. You will not remain there for a long time. The devil is a liar. If God be for us, who can be against us? If God is on your side, power is on your side, anointing is on your side, favor is on your side. Lift your legs, shout yes, 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 yes. Take your seat. Shout access. Take your seat. There are access you can't have until you break some resistance. There are access that you require force to break through. Numbers 21:21. If you can get me that scripture, we'll be glad. Numbers 21:21. Do we have them on the screen or we should read it? We have Numbers 21:21. I have discovered that there are people that will not give you access until you clear them. There are powers. Let's read it together. And Israel sent messenger unto Sion, king of the Amorites, saying, continue to 23. Let me pass through your land. We will not turn into the field or into the vineyard. We will not drink of the waters of the well. We will go along the king highway until we be past thy borders. Verse 23. And Sion will not suffer Israel to pass. Hit your neighbor, say, let me pass. Come on, hit your neighbor, say, let me pass. Can I prophesy? Whoever say you will not pass must be buried. Whoever say you will not cross the line must go down. Whatever fought your breakthrough must collapse. Somebody shall let me pass. Take your seat. Hear me. In some family, there is an invisible line that they have drawn that nobody can pass. Whether you are in Nigeria or you are in America or you are in Dubai, as long as you share that blood, there is an invisible line that says nobody can pass. Your father came, he couldn't cross. Your mother came, she couldn't cross. Your brother went to America, he came there, he couldn't cross. Your aunties came, they couldn't cross. You managed to enter Dubai. You came, you couldn't cross. Tonight, I command you, cross. I say 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 cross. Lift up your hands, say I'm a line crosser. Say I'm a line crosser. Say I'm a barrier breaker. Say I'm a line crosser. I'm a barrier breaker. Shout I'm a line crosser. Shout, I'm a barrier breaker. Shout, I'm a line crosser.
I'm a barrier breaker. Can I prophesy to 59 people? You will cross that line. Where your father stopped, that is where you will start. Where they say you can't reach, you will reach by force. What they say you can't handle, your hand will carry it. That thing they say you will never see, your life will embrace it. The devil is a liar. Somebody will cross. I say you will cross. I say you will cross. The devil is a liar. Nobody has crossed into marriage, receive power to cross. Nobody has become a millionaire, receive power to be monetated. Power to be monetated. Lift up your hand, say, I must cross. Hit your neighbor, say, I must be monetated. I must be monified. I must be monicious. Say, I must be monified. Say, I smell monious.
Take your seat. Can I pray for some people here? Can I pray for some people here? Whether they like it or yes, you must succeed. You must succeed. You didn't hear me. I say you must succeed. Can I pray for somebody here? Whoever say behind my dead body for you to marry, behind my dead body for you to be mummified, I dig the ground and bury them. Shall let me pass. Take your seat. I preach this kind of brutal message. Take your seat. I was coming out, going to the, leaving the hall. One of my daughters stood in my front like this. And the protocol wanted to clear her. I said, the road is big. I'll follow the other side. Don't mind her. I don't know what she took today that she's blocking her father in the Lord. Let me pass there. Maybe I wanted to go that way. She moved. I want to go this way. She moved. I said, you drink Igbo. Did you take weed? Don't you know it's your man of God? I said, I know. But you will not pass. Did you not said that the anointing I need is in my man of God? I said, yes. Did you not say that the grace I need is in my man of God? I say yes. Did you not say the husband I need is in my man of God? I say yes. He said, release my husband now. If you don't release my husband, you will not go. I say, I'm not holding your husband. I say, Papa, it looks like you are joking. If you don't release my husband now, you will marry me here now. When I had marry me, I said, kneel down. I said, kneel down. She knelt down. I said, Father, this lady wants to embarrass me. And I cannot be embarrassed by the anointing. I represent you. Please, oh God, give her 7 husbands at once. That she will learn not to attack a man of God. Give her 7 in the name of Jesus. When she was shouting, amen, I have passed and left. Somebody shout, let me pass. Had left. 2 weeks after man of God, 10 men came to marry her. 10. As if they opened their eyes. He said, Papa, I'm dead. I said, you are alive. You cannot die. He said, sometimes 4 or 5 in my parlor eyeing each other. What will I do? I said, come. Choose one out of them. He said, you don't understand. They all look alike. I don't know which one to choose. I said, this is a good problem. I said, come. Let's choose one. When she came out, I said, kneel down. She kneeled. I said, Father, make it 15. That she will learn not to attack a man of God. She said, I don't die. I said, no, you shall live. She fell on the ground and I walked away. 1 month, 2 weeks, she had 17 men ready to marry her. She called me at the airport, said, I'm running for my life. I'm in Abuja airport, running to Lagos. They want to kill me, Papa. They are bombarding. If I'm changing my number, I said, come back. Say, no. If I come back, you will increase. I said, no, come back. I will increase it. You mean 17 men? You don't know which one. He said, you don't understand. I'm trying to get this one. This one will show up. I'm trying to. It looks like from better. I don't know what to do before I choose the wrong one because it is too real to be true. I said, come back. He said, no, you will increase it. I said, no, I won't. Come back. So she came. She canceled the flight. She came. I said, write their names. She wrote 17 names. When I saw 17 names, I decided to speak in tongues in capital letters. Somebody say capital letters. You are fired. Jacqualakata. Any name I touch, Nendros, you are fired. Melukas Kopranti Kalustia, fired. Nyanton Shamianda Gatoyondos, fired. Nyankon Tomiyandan Chuan Chuan Dinchon Tomiyanda, fired. Nyankon Tomi Rando Shan Chuan Kanton Komayan Don Josh, marry this one. And today she's married with a baby, chopping life with 35 acres. If she did not insist, she won't cross the line. Many of you are too gentle. Gentility in the spirit, in the physical, is a blessing, but in the spirit it is a curse. Are you following what I'm saying here? To remain an active participant in the game of life, you must be ruggedized. You must be brutalious. You must be sagacious. You must be full of rudidity, rascality, and brutality. Am I talking to somebody here? You must move your life with dengecious anointing. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying here? There is something that must answer to you this week. There's a favor that must come to your life in these 7 days. Lift up your hand, shall let me pass. Can I prophesy to somebody? Life will give you passage. Marriage will give you passage. Business will give you opening. Something is opening for somebody. If God be for us, who can be against us? Take your seat. So it's a breaking. Breaking of limitations, restrictions, barriers that hinders our pursuit for physical and spiritual substances. Because we, pastor, we are pursuing spiritual substances. We can be resisted in the land. For the souls of men, we need to break some cocoons. We need to break some gypsies and tohunkasis of darkness to have certain access. Am I talking to somebody here? Even if they curse you from the womb, I came to remove that curse. Money must enter your hand. I did not come to play with you. I didn't come to apologize to you. I came to force you into your access, into your blessing, into your breakthrough. There is blessing in this land. Your hand must carry it. Take your seat. Take your seat. Take your seat. What are the products of access? Number one product of access is breakthrough. Somebody say breakthrough. Can I prophesy to somebody? Anytime God gives you access, the end product of access is what? Breakthrough. What is breakthrough? Number one, breakthrough is the breaking of barriers. Somebody say the breaking of barriers. The conquering of obstacles. And the preeminence over stumbling blocks. It is the breaking of barrier. It is the conquering of obstacles and the surmounting over stumbling blocks. What is breakthrough, sir? Breakthrough, sir, is outstanding performance regardless of antagonizing circumstances. It is what? Outstanding performance regardless of antagonistic circumstances and conditions. What is breakthrough? Breakthrough is the forceful displacement of restriction and the forceful remover of resistance. The forceful displacements of restriction and the forceful remover of resistance. What is breakthrough? Breakthrough, child of God, is the eradication of obstructions, the triumphing over stumbling blocks, and of course, the incomparability over antagonistic circumstances. What is breakthrough? Breakthrough, number 7, child of God, is the multivarietism. Someone say multivarietism. By a magnetic intrusionalization conquest of your environment. Someone say multivarietism. Someone say multivarietism. Someone say multivarietism. Of your intrusionalization conquest of your environment. When you conquer your Dubai, that is breakthrough, my friend. When your product swallow this land, that is breakthrough. Am I talking to somebody here? When your intellectual properties is being sold all over Dubai, that is breakthrough. When what you have to offer to your generation is being celebrated by all our sundry, that is breakthrough. Can I prophesy to somebody? You will break through by force. You will break through by force. You will break through by force. What is breakthrough? Breakthrough is the symptomatic chromatographic occupation of your atmospheric anthropospheric environment for a frugal economy. Someone say symptomatic and chromatographic occupation of your atmospheric anthropospheric environment for frugal economy. Is somebody hearing what God is saying? Can I prophesy to somebody? God will give you frugal economy.
That means it is not going to be arithmetical. It is not going to be additional. It's going to be geometric. Am I talking to somebody here? 1 + 1 is arithmetical. Am I talking to somebody here? Is somebody hearing what I'm saying here? Is what? Arithmetical. But hear me. Well, 4 times 4, that is multiplicative. But hear me, child of God. 4 raised to power 4, that is geometric. Am I talking to somebody here? Can I prophesy? God will move you from arithmetical to multiplicative, from multiplicative to geometric. So breakthrough is the vertical and horizontal direction movement into your dreams and expectations. Somebody today is breaking forth on every side. Take your seat. Breakthrough, sir, is the encroachment into a desired territory for the purpose of opportunity and prosperity. Somebody say encroachment. There are breakthroughs you don't have until you encroach. Joshua chapter 15 verse 63. God gave Joshua the land of the Jebusite, the Canaanite, the Perizzite, the Hittite, the Hivite, the Perizzite. Their job is to ken the Canaanite, perish the Perizzite, take the Jebusite out of sight. But hear me, as much as God gave them, it never became a breakthrough until somebody encroached. Look at what the scripture said. Joshua chapter 15 and verse number 63. Joshua 15 and verse 63. Let's look at what the Bible said. Let's read it together. I want to go. And for the Jebusites, the inhabitants of Jerusalem, the children of Judah, could not drive them out. But the Jebusites dwell with the children of Judah at Jerusalem until this day. Though it is given, but it has to be taken. It is God, it is in God to give, but it is in your responsibility to take. Am I talking to somebody here? So many of you, God has given, but you are not taking. Today you will take it. He gave them. Jebusite possessed Jerusalem. The Jerusalem everybody wants to go for pilgrimage was in the hand of the enemy, and God had given them. Bible said Joshua could not drive them, and they remain in Jerusalem till this day. Until a radical like me, by the name David, came on the scene in 1 Chronicles chapter 11, verse 4. 1 Chronicles 11, verse 4. Joshua came, he could not conquer. Ruth could not drive them out. Jephthah could not drive them out. Gideon could not drive them out. Samson could not drive them out. Prophet Samuel could not drive them out. Saul could not drive them out. Until a pugnacious, audacious, truculent entity by the name David. The Bible says, and David and all Israel went to Jerusalem, which is Jebus. Someone say Jebus. Where the Jebusites were, the inhabitants of the land. That means Jerusalem was their own. And what happened? And the next verse. And the inhabitants of Jebus said to David, thou shalt not come hither. Don't even try it. Jebusites are 9-footed men. The least is 9 foot. Some of them are 12 feet. Some of them are 15. That means for every average human being in Israel, they are below the knees. The kneels of the Jebusites. So the Jebusites stood and said, don't come near here. He said, you want to die? Don't try it. Bible said, nevertheless, despite resistance, despite unfavorable condition, despite that the situation is not good for immigrants, Bible said, nevertheless, David took the castle of Zion. Somebody will take his money today. Somebody will take his husband. Somebody will take his breakthrough. Somebody will take his favor. Lift up your hand and say, I take it. Say, Satan, you can't stop me. I take it. It's mine. I, man of God. David took the castle of Zion. He took it. Then the next verse, the Bible said, and David said, whoever go and bring down the Jebusite shall become chief of defense staff. And David said, to whosoever smite the Jebusite first shall be chief of defense staff and chief of army staff captains. So Joab, the son of Zeruiah, went up and was made chief of defense staff. That means he cleared the Jebusite that is today that belongs to Israel. It took a man to enforce his prophecy. Many of you are carrying prophecy of greatness, of millionaire status. God spoke to you individually through the scriptures you read. Some of you men of God pick you one by one and spoke some details like, tomorrow I'll be prophesying till I sit on the floor. You heard all kinds of messages that could spoil your life, yet your life does not resemble your prophetic word. Your seed does not agree agree with your harvest. Some of you, your expectation is fighting your manifestation. Your desire is fighting your reality. I pray for somebody here. By the power of encroachment, by the mystery of breakthrough, I command you, step into it. I say, step into it. I say, step into it. Somebody shall break through. Take your seat. What are the products of access? What are the benefits of access? Number two, supernatural shift. Not only do you have breakthrough, but you shift. You move from single to married. You move from tenant to landlord. You move from landlord to owner of estate. You move from owner of estate to raising of a village to a city. And that's what some of us are doing in Nigeria. Turning bush to cities. Somebody shout, change. Say, shift. Shout it louder. Can I pray for somebody? There is a shift God is giving you this season. Those that used to know you before will be shocked where they will see you after 3 months. Give somebody a high five. Say, I'm shifting level. I'm shifting level. I'm shifting level. I'm shifting level. You will not find me where you left me. You will not find me where you left me. You will not find me where you left me. Somebody shall shift. Shout it louder. One more time. God. Shift is the transfiguration from humanity to divinity. Is the word transfiguration from humanity to divinity. Supernatural shift is a spiritual relocation for physical allocation. Someone say spiritual relocation for physical allocation. Many of you, the things that you are looking for, you can't get it because you are wrongly positioned spiritually. For God to bless Abraham, to move him from the land of Uz of the Chaldeans to Cana, for him to be blessed. When the baby in the womb of a mother is wrongly positioned, caesarean section is required. Hear me, everything is about right positioning in life. If you are wrongly positioned, you cannot be blessed. Many of you are here physically, but spiritually you are wrongly positioned. You are positioned before an altar. You are positioned before a shrine. There are covenants over your head that fight your progress. So you are wrongly positioned. So anytime God will give you supernatural shift, there will be spiritual relocation for physical allocation. What is supernatural shift? It is the conversion of an ordinary life to a transgenerational audience. Somebody say the conversion of an ordinary life to a transgenerational audience. It's a situation where Jacob became Israel. My friend, that is a shift. It's a situation where you move from a fearful, fidgeted looking Gideon to become man who manifested the might of a nation. This was a man who was fearful, who was a man who had given up, who was afraid of the Midianite. But the angel said to him, go in this thy might, for you will slay the Midianite as one man. That means God gave him the strength of a nation. One man's strength was equated to a nation. David had a shift such that Israel said, you won't go to war anymore. Lest you quench the light of Israel. One man became a light of a nation. It's a transgenerational movement. It's a situation where an individual becomes an institution. Where one man operates with the might of a nation. The other day I heard Elisha say to Elijah, my father, the chariots of Israel. That means one man was equated to the armory of a nation. That means a strength, military might of a nation was equated to Elijah. That is to touch Elijah is to touch the chariots of Israel. And not only the chariots, the horsemen. Horsemen. You, only you. You'll be bigger than 100 children in that family. You didn't hear what I said. Only one daughter. You'll be better than 50 boys. You will do this in your family that your father will not remember I had other children. You don't understand what I am talking about. You are living here not as an individual. You are living here with the might of a nation. You are living here with the strength of a nation. You are living here with the weapon of a nation. From today, a a small among you shall be great, and a little among you shall be like a David, and a small shall be a nation. Can I prophesy? Somebody is receiving a shift. Don't look down on me, because I am not alone. I am too loaded. I must be needed. I am too loaded. I must be celebrated. I am too surrounded so that I cannot surrender. I am too protected and defended to be arrested.
Move from ordinary life to supernatural transgenerational orders. He said, my father, the chariots of Israel, one man became a chariot. There are people that they have moved to be individual. They are nations. When Samuel entered Bethlehem, the whole nation shook the town. The Bible says, and all the elders came to the gate and said, commence thou peaceably. Because the movement of Samuel is a movement of oracles. You will not be ordinary again. Just only you. Your mother will fly to US. Your father will have houses. Only you. Four of your brothers will run their own businesses. Only you. Only you. Only you. Don't wait for how many are we? Why am I the only one suffering? No. You are going with the might of a nation. Your supply alone will swallow the supply of your village. Your only supply, your personal supply, will swallow all the young men in your village. The might of a nation. Your father is saying he has only girls. He has only girls. No boys. Wait first. When you manifest, your father will look at you and say you are better than 200 boys. I'm talking to some ladies here. That you are married, you are not cursed. You can manifest. You can manifest. You are not an individual. You are a nation. You are what? A nation. Open your hands and prophesy. These two services you will have with me. By the time God will through, even the color of your skin will change. After this service, your walking step will change. If you are walking like a vulture, you will spread your legs. And spread your shoulder and walk braggadociously as if you own Dubai, because the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and all those that dwell therein. Because if God is for me, who can fight me? Somebody say, shift. Do you like this? Shift. Can I prophesy to somebody? By the fire. When I finish this prayer, change your seat with somebody. Spiritually, it will happen. Am I talking to somebody here? In the name of the resurrected Christ, Jesus, Son of the living God, within 24 hours from now, they will not meet you where they left you. I command you, receive your shift. Change here with another person. Change position. Change here. You must not sit on the same seat. Change the chair. As you are doing it spiritually, something has happened. Spiritually, something has happened. Spiritually, something has happened. Lift up your hand and say, there is a shift. Sit down and cross your leg. Don't leave that seat. Sit down there. It's a shift already. Don't leave that seat. Sit down there. Sit there. Cross your leg. Tell your neighbor, I'm in charge. Can I talk to somebody here? But the next time they look for you, they will not meet you in that side of the town. They will not meet you in that careless part of the town. They will meet you in the center of happenings. Things are changing. When the Lord turn again, the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. Can I talk to somebody here? Receive supernatural shifts. Take your seat. Take your seat. My friend, I call it supernatural access. I didn't call it access. Because if we wait for your effort, you may die without entering certain things. You need supernatural capabilities. When we say supernatural, we are talking about precipitating divine involvement in natural matters. What did I say? Precipitating divine involvement in natural matter. When we say supernatural acts, what God will do for you is not natural. If we leave you like that, 10 years, you will still go back to the village and be explaining. Today, I came to turn your explanation to exclamation. Take your seat. We came to bring an extra hand on your life. Something heavier than you. I used to be in Jos. 10 years ago, I moved to Abuja, Nigeria. When I entered Abuja, I discovered that men of God have shared the town. Some men of God holding 5 services, 4 services, 3 services. When I enter, everybody is busy growing his church. I told God, reshare this town. Give me my portion. Reshare it. Someone say, reshare. I said, you must reshare it too. I spoke in tongues in capital letter. Reshare the town. By the time God finished reshare, I took my portions in thousands. Can I prophesy to somebody? If they have already shared this town, I reshare it. I reshare this town. I reshare this town. Take your seat. As we run towards Expo 2020, this land will be full of opportunities. May your brain wake up. May your mind come alive. Receive ideas. Receive concepts. Receive revelation. May God speak to you through dreams. May your eyes open. May your mind open. May your understanding open. Take your seat. You don't need to do drugs to rise. Your mind will come alive. Jacob was laboring for labor for 20 years until God touched his mind. When God touched his mind, he gave him a blessing of 1 year that swallowed 20 years of labor. Put your hand on your head. I don't care how many years you've been in this land. May God prove his name mighty. May he give you 1 year blessing that will reward your many years. 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 Somebody shout fire. Take your seat. Because of time, what will it take? I just gave you benefit, just two. We say one is what? Breakthrough. Two, supernatural shift. What will it take to have supernatural access? My friend, it will take power. Go like this, power. Take your seat. Do it again, power. Every object is in a state of rest until a power rests on it. It takes it. Life is a journey from point A to point B. What takes you from point A to point B is power. We're in the wall of power. This generation is in dire need of power. We have all kinds of power. We have economic power, political power, occultic power, nuclear war power. And we also have spiritual power. And spiritual power exceeds all power. Because he that is from above is above all. Somebody say above all. Shout it louder. Only spiritual power can temper with other powers. Because if you have political power, one witch can sit on your intestine. It takes a man with spiritual power to remove it. Yes. Former president of Zambia, he was hearing noise and flogging on his bed. He had to invite my friend and fly him with private jet. My friend tell him to sleep on the ground, he will sleep on his bed to remove the devil. So even when he had monies, but he lacked spiritual power, because one Sangoma, one native doctor, one Dibia, one Alpha put him in that condition. So we have educational power. That is the power of the wall of the academia. But hear me, intellectual power is there. But hear me, spiritual power is the greatest of all power. And hear me, when you have it, you can interplay it in politics. You can intercept it in your finances. You can intercept it in your business. You can intercept it in your career, in your marriage, in your profession. And this will shift. It's your power. So power, therefore, is the essentiality of spiritualism manifesting on the homo sapient. What did I say? Power is the essentiality of spiritualism manifesting on the homo sapient. You are homo sapien. Every human being is homo sapien. It's the essence for spirituality. So if you are spiritual and you have no power, you have wasted spirituality. Every fast effort you make spiritually supposed to end you in power. If you fast, must end you in power. If you pray, must end you in power. If you give, it must end you in financial power. If you come to church, you are supposed to add strength. You have to have physical and spiritual power, because they went from strength to strength, every one of them that appeared before him in Zion. So it is the essentiality of spiritualism manifesting on the homo sapiens. So anytime power, anytime you do spiritual exercise, anytime you give, anytime you fast, anytime you pray, anytime you consistently come to a service and heavy high tension apostolic ministry is unleashed, the end product is power. The outcome of these 2 days is power. Power, power. You are no longer at the same height. Spiritually, your level has changed. You can now confront the things you couldn't confront. Because if you lack power, anything can mess you up. Anything can mess you up. So power, therefore, number two, is the superimposition of strange influence to change a condition, a location, a situation in favor of the demonstrators. Someone say power. Is the superimposition to change a condition, a situation, a location in favor of the demonstrator. So when power comes, conditions can be changed. Location can be changed. Situation can be changed. A single girl can become married. An individual can become an institution. All by power. It's a superimposition of strange influence to change a condition. What is power? Power is the extra in the ordinary, the super in the natural. Bringing out intention, expectations, and visions of the individual. Power is what? Are you ready? It's the extra in the ordinary, the super in the natural. Bringing out intention, expectations, and visions of the individual. That is to say, where there is power, intentions are established. Where there is power, visions are achieved. Where there is power, expectations are granted. When you carry expectation, it is not fulfilled. It's because the power to bring it to pass is not there. So where there is power, sir, extra receive the ordinary, receive the extra. The natural receive the super. So that there can be change of condition. So that intentions can be interpreted. Vision can be realized. And expectation can be actualized. Someone shall power.
Power.
Someone shall power.
Power.
What is power? Power is the expression of immortality, infinity, divinity, spiritualism, celestialism on time, space, and matter. Power is the expression of divinity, infinity, celestialism, spiritualism. Am I talking to somebody here? On time and time, matters, and space. I want 3 people with suit. Come. Face here. God bless you. Stand here. This is you. This is your destiny. This is you. This is your vision. What you want to achieve in Dubai. For some of you, you want to be a commander of finances. For some of you, you want to be a mighty landlord, owner of estates. For some of you, you want to be empowered to become a massive mega politician. For some of you, you want to be a mega trader. For some of you, you want to be a territorial commander in this land. So these are your dreams, these are your expectations, these are your intentions. But hear me, between you and your manifestation is time, space, and matter. Between you and destiny is time. Some of you take 20 years, 30 years, 15 years to reach there. Between you and destiny is a space. Even if you try to reach, you can't reach there because there is a gap between you and destiny. Between you and destiny is a matter that does not want you to matter. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. But when power comes on you, time, space, and matter is removed. There is arrival. Means where there is power, there is arrival without journey. There is attainment without steps. There is marriage without dating. There is husband without courting.
There is money without sweat. There is glory without glory. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. Take power. 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 Lift your legs on fire. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Go to your seat. So anytime power comes on you, it gives immortality expression. You can disappear and reappear by power. A Muslim young lady gave her life to Christ in my church. It was an anointing service. We closed the service. I blessed oil. She went out, bought her oil. I blessed it. She went to Area 1, going to Lube. She entered one chance. Occultic people. Car. They are all over Nigeria. They'll just rub handkerchief on your face. You collapse. You pass out. You only appear where ritualists are. They will use vital organs of your body to renew wealth. So when they put the thing on her face, she slept off. She didn't open her eyes until after Kaduna, 3 hours. She was heading to Mando, that is the airport, the detour on the left, on the right, sorry. And they started going 2 hours on that road. She said when she recovered herself, she opened her eyes, she saw herself in between two men. And two men also, the driver and another man in front, two men in between her, and she's in the middle. They were taking her. So she pretended to be sleeping. Something told her, if you get to your destination, they may separate you with your bag. So do something now. So she pretended and stretched her hand into her bag and took the anointing oil I blessed. She carried it and hid it somewhere here. And she pretended. When they got there, they got to ritual camp. They saw human beings in cage. And these alhajis, northern state alhajis, that uses people's vital organs to renew their wealth and their blessings. So she was in that cage for 3 days, no water, no food. They kept her there. Her family came and said, we know our daughter does not belong to your religion, but the last place they saw her was your church. Produce her for us. I said, I don't know her. But if she come here, she cannot be lost. Nothing dies in Mount Zion. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying here? Somebody shout, nothing dies in Mount Zion. So I said to them, let's pray. So I prayed. I broke the chain. Somebody said, break the chain. Break the chain. So I said to them, she will be back. So on the third day, she was looking frail and tired. They carried her to go slaughter her. Then I asked her, do your last prayer before we cut it off. She now stopped. The man pushed her. He said, move. He said, but you said I should do my last prayer. He said, yes, let me pray. He said, okay. She now pulled out the oil. She said, God of Talena, I don't know you too well, but I just gave my life a few days ago. And I heard the man of God said, when mortality fails, we should cross to immortality. When the terrestrial fails, we should cross to the celestial. When natural fails, we should cross to the supernatural. If truly you are a God, show yourself. She poured the oil on the ground, emptied the oil, and stepped on the oil. Guess what happened to this girl? She disappeared. Guess where she appeared? She appeared in Area 1, the very spot where they took her. Are you looking at me? My members are disappearing anyhow. There are people in accident. Even last Sunday, we received one testimony. Accident. They asked her, are you inside this car? Because as the accident took place, they saw her coming from another spot. Coming. And her bag kept outside. Everybody dead in blood. That I'm talking about the expression of immortality. Infinity, divinity, and celestialism on time, space, and matter. Where time has no influence on your life. Where the arrows of the wicked cannot come near you. I was preaching in Toronto, Canada, when they called me that a woman, her only child, 17 years, has just died. And this is the fourth child that just died and her husband is dead. She came to the church because they told her that for them not to kill the last baby, she has to come to Talena's church. And the husband, younger brother, had boasted that he will wipe everybody because of property. And now that girl came back from, the mother came back from business and saw the last girl say, Mama, I've been having headache on my head for 6 months. The mother said, have you taken any paracetamol? I've taken more than 3 times. The mother said, okay, give me water. Let me drink so that I take you to the pharmacy so that we can treat you. Maybe it's malaria. Sorry, my daughter. She went and carried water and bring to the mother. She was giving the mother. She was going back. Before the mother could grab the water, she fell on the ground and passed out. Rushed out to the hospital. Doctor confirmed her dead. The woman said, no way. Not when I joined this church. Not when I'm hearing this kind of message. She bundled the child. She brought the baby to the altar and dropped the child. They have prayed for several hours. So I came out of the service and the phone still rang. I picked it. They said, this is what happened. I said, give it to the woman. I said, madam, what happened? She said, this is the situation. So I spoke in tongues for 17 minutes on the stretch. After 17 minutes, I asked her any sign. She said, no sign. I said, madam, start thanking God and dancing. Start dancing. Praise God. If after 15 minutes nothing happened, take the child to the mortuary. I will personally do the burial and I will pay the bills. The woman shouted, no! I said, why? He said, that is not what you taught us. I said, what did I teach you? You said that when the terrestrial fail, we should cross to the celestial. When mortality fails us, immortality will evade. If that thing you are preaching is true, then your God must manifest. Sir, I did not come for you. I came for your God. I said to her, don't be angry. Oh, yeah, start dancing. Start dancing. She started dancing and praising God. She climbed my altar, dance. And I forgot and I left a handkerchief the previous Sunday on the ground that failed. And she danced, saw an handkerchief, she carried it. She danced and danced and danced and laid on the girl. The girl sneezed and came back to life. They were calling me, I refused to pick because I don't want to hear no. They call, I refused to pick. Suddenly my resident pastor sent a text. Papa, the girl has bounced back to life. I call, I say, what happened? What happened? What happened? Am I talking to somebody here? When the Lord turned again, the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. I have a good news for somebody. Power is coming upon your life. Anointing is falling on your life. God is changing your level playing ground. Somebody shout, power!
Open your hands. I prophesy the kind of power you need to move from point A to point B. If you have a dream, if you ever had a vision, if you ever had an intention, if you ever had an expectation, you are my customer this morning. I came to move you. I come like a towing van. I come like a caterpillar without brake. I came to jack you up. I must tow you to your destiny. Listen, even if a car has no tires, when a towing van comes, I'll hook the car. Whether the car has tire or not, the car must move. Somebody will move. Somebody will move. You will not be at the same spot. I see a divine shift. God is giving you unusual access. Doors are opening unto you. Somebody shall, Lord, I need the touch of your power.
Take your seat. Man of God, even in ministry, take your seat. If you don't have power, I'm sorry for you. Any laws can deal with you. Anybody can kill you. I'm telling you. I pick a young man in church and I prophesied on him. Tomorrow I'll prophesy tired. Because I'm seeing so many cases here. I pick a young man, I say, stand up. I say, your name is David. He says, yes. I say, your father is occultic. He was looking at me. I say, your father belongs to 11 cults. He was looking at me. I say, you are the firstborn. He says, yes. I say, your father used all your stars to renew his wealth. He's a rich man. He says, yes. I say, you remember your father gave you 36 million to start business. He said, it didn't last 1 month. You didn't know where the money is. He said, yes. He gave you another 20 million. They say, he gave you, last week, he gave you 5 million. As I'm talking now, you don't even have up to 500,000 in your hand. He said, yes. I say, it's your star. And even if your father give you 1 billion, you will never be useful in your hands until I tell you what to do. So wait for me after service. I will tell you what to do. David did not wait for service to close. He left, went home and carried cutlass. He sharpened it. Point to the father and say, return my star. Or one of us will die today. Give me my star. Before I know, David pursued his father with cutlass. They ran two kilometers. And it was on a Wednesday service I gave that message. That same night, he pursued his father with cutlass. The father didn't sleep at home. The following day, Thursday, the father came with trucks of police. More than 11 policemen, 2 trucks to arrest me. They came back, a cat, sang, pa, pa, pa. They came out, enter. Where's the man of God? Bring him out, bring that pastor out. The man was bushy. Where's the pastor? And he was, and God, he thanked his God. I traveled to Port Harcourt that morning for program. So my wife called me, said, sweetheart, have you landed? I said, yes. He said, this is your prophecy I've been telling you. Must you prophesy? Just preach. You are a preacher. I say, woman, keep quiet. Is it me that want to prophesy? As it is, doing me. So I'm talking and talking.
I see they do me now, they talk up. Huh? You say, why? Every time you prophesy, remember you have children and a wife. I said, what is the problem? He said, that boy, David, prophesied yesterday that his father is rich here. Said the chief is here to arrest you here with police. I said, how dare that chief dare me? You see here, he said, yes. I said, give him the phone. I gave him phone. I said, chief, he said, stupid, useless pastor, where are you? I will teach you how to spell occultism by the time I finish with you. I said, chief, you are very lucky that I travel. But I'll be back on Saturday by 4 p.m. Please, chief, if you are coming, don't come with only police. Bring Mopo, bring army, bring navy, bring air force, bring boys brigade, bring civil defense, bring boy scout, bring road safety, bring VIO. I'm telling you, because I'm a caterpillar without break. You don't arrest oracle like that. Say, stupid pastor, we shall see. I say, chief, if you enter my church with your two legs, I will backslide. I will backslide and join the religion of my people in the north. I will backslide. I will stop serving God. If you enter this church with your two legs, it means there's no power. Anywhere. From the day I became born again, I knew power. He said, we shall see. I said, we shall see. Man of God. On Friday night, knowing well that trouble is waiting for me on Saturday, I woke up midnight, 2 a.m., spoke in tongues in capital letters. Vebru shivrikitus. Nando shiki. Vekwalakatu. Braya shiki lakotos. I, Joshua Talena, project myself in the realm of the spirit. Chief, I jam you like a caterpillar without break. I temper with your kidney and your liver. I temper with your pancreas and your esophagus. I command you go into a state of comatose. Somebody shout comatose. I command you to pass out. Saturday I came. Sat in the office from 4 to 8 o'clock. Chief didn't come. Sunday morning, run multiple services. He didn't come. Monday, run lunch hour. He didn't come. Around 4 p.m., I'm hearing, Pastor, there are falling people crying. I peeped through the window. I saw Chief's wife and David and the rest crying and falling. I told my resident pastor, it has happened. Chief is under attack for these people to be crying. So I left them in the reception to cry for another 1 hour as a punishment first. Since he said he will arrest me. So after 1 hour, I came. I said, what is it? He said, Chief is in National Hospital on oxygen. When this happened, he said, on Saturday. I said, but he said he was coming to arrest me. He said, please have mercy on us. The wife said, I don't want him to die. Please, he can still repent. David said, Papa, I beg you. Let him return my staff first. If he wants to die, let him die. Then let him give us our star. Abi, you want him to die with our star? I said, no. He said, then do something, sir. I said, okay, let's go. So we went to the National Hospital where Chief was. I saw him in oxygen and I started rubbing his head. Okay, sit down. Sorry, I'll be using your head because your head looks like Chief's head. It was shining like this. Don't be angry. I will bless you. I was rubbing his head and using style to slap him. I said, Chief, return. When I remember arrest, I will give him power. Chief, return back to your senses. Kill a ghost. I told doctor, it's not a medical case. It's spiritual. That thing I put inside, I came to remove it. Nandos, Nangolobos, Vebras, Iaguas, Legodos. When I spoke in tongues for 15 minutes, Chief started opening his eyes like a convulsing patient. I said, Chief, I said, I thought you said you arrest me. I said, arrest me now. And I said, I said, Chief, you have 72 hours to tell your children who you are. Otherwise, I will return you to this hospital from here to the mortuary. Except God did not call me. He said, I said, Chief, 72 hours. I turned to the doctor. I said, that thing I put, I don't remove him. He's not a medical. Discharge him. I left around 8 o'clock. By 11, they discharged Chief. By Wednesday, Chief called me. He said, he confessed that he belonged to 11 called. He is the chairman of Boni Fraternity in Kano State. He called some Yoruba kind of calls that he belonged to. He was even in Amok Resecution. He's in Oboni and all of those places. And he said, please pray for me. They are after me since I confessed to my children. They want to kill me. I said, come here. I let him Christ, got him filled with the Holy Ghost. He spoke in tongues, and that was the end. Today, David do breakfast in Nigeria, lunch in London, dinner in New York. Someone say breakfast in Nigeria, lunch in London, dinner in US. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying here? Chopping life with 35 fingers.
He had 10 fingers. He borrowed the fingers of his enemy and had. That thing they say you will never become. Power has arrived. You didn't hear me. I said power has arrived. Even if they curse you from the womb, even if they limit you from your father's house, whoever said this will not work in your hand, whoever said come and marry, let me see, I come in the volume of the book, I come in the power of the Holy Ghost, I come in the spirit of the resurrected Christ. The Egyptian you have seen today, you shall see them again no more. The devil is coming down. Altars are catching fire. Shrines are catching fire. Anywhere they are working against you, they are going down. They are going down. You are going down. You are going down. You are going down. You are going down. Lift your legs, shut fire. Lift your hands, shut fire. Shake your body, shut fire. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Take your seat. Finally, for this service, because tomorrow we shall serve everybody communion. Blood service. Tomorrow is blood service. If possible, all of you bring communion materials. So that if you have gone, you will take communion for 7 days. Your humanity will be swallowed by your divinity. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying here? People drink human blood and change levels. You will drink the blood of Jesus. Am I talking to somebody here? Your level will change. And anyone that vow you can't move must die. You are in the land of opportunity. You will not die of scarcity. You are in the land of plenty. You will not die empty. This is a land of vision. An ordinary man turn a desert to a city. Ordinary man turn a desert without oil to a city. And you are in this kind of environment. You must see vision. Oh. You must catch revelation. Something must change. Something must change. Something must change. Something must change. I see dry bones shaking. I see bone to bone. Sinew to sinew, muscle to muscles, tender to tender. Something is shifting. Tomorrow, take your seat. Tomorrow, no matter the business, cancel it. I'm coming with 500 mantles to give to anybody that brings 2 persons. Carry anybody, whether he like or not, carry him, put in your car. If your car is full, put him in the trunk, put him in the boot. If there is no human being to bring, carry the dog in your house and bring. Did you hear what I said? If there are no human being on the street of Dubai, carry dog, carry your goat, your chicken, put inside the car. Something must carry something. You didn't hear? Something. I came with fire. I came with fire. Somebody must carry something. Finally, in this service, take your seat. What will it take to gain access to the things you want in life? Number one, it will take power. Number two, you must be a spiritual trader in spiritual goods. You must be a trader in spiritual goods. You must be a good trader in spiritual matters. Hear me, assets are fought by words and by blood. You must be a trader of words and a trader of blood. If you are a Christian and you don't know how to talk, you'll be buried. The most powerful religion in the world is a religion that speaks. I came from an Islamic feasted area. They speak. A few minutes from now, you will hear the cry. They are also speaking. Speaking to their God. If you are a Catholic, there is a chaplet. They chant with Holy Mary, rosary, full of grace. They chant. It's a speaking a denomination. You are a child of God. You are a Pentecostal. Or you are an Orthodox. They tell you to pray. You say you are praying in your heart. You are finished. Hosea 14 verse 1 and 2 said, when you go before God, go with words. Go with what? Words. You must be buoyant in scriptures. Job 13, 19. Job said, if I hold my tongue, I will give up the ghost. If you keep quiet, you will be buried. So to remain an active participant in the game of life, you must be an active speaker. If you don't know how to speak, you'll be buried. Because the most notorious native doctors are those that speak. No native doctor can harm you until he speaks. Can I talk to somebody here?
what enchantment is to unbelievers, that is what prophesying is to a child of God. I will go deeper tomorrow. Where you need to learn to speak. And if you don't have Bible words in your spirit, you can't speak. Speaking for a child of God must be a product of buoyancy of scriptures. Because John 6:63 said, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. So you must learn to speak. Words are spiritual entity. Words are mobile spirits. The Bible said in Isaiah 55:11, so is my word that goeth out of my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but shall accomplish the purpose for which I sent it. So the word of God is a mobile answer. So if you don't know how to speak, if you don't know how to speak God's word in prayer, over your condition, speaking until things change, my friend, you'll be buried where you are still alive. You must learn to speak, because the battle of the spirits are won by words and won by blood. So if you're a Christian and you don't know how to talk, you don't know how to pray, people have to pray for you. I'm sorry for you. It's better you go join occult so that they will help you chant, so that you can chant well, because occult, they will discipline you if you don't know how to talk. You must learn to chant. Then you come to church. You are playing with your Bible. You are playing with scriptures. And you want to succeed. Do you hear me? This life is first spiritual before it becomes physical. Are you richer than the sheikhs in this town? But every Friday, you hear them chanting. During their fast, they chant. You came here and see people serious with what they are doing. And you came here as a Christian, you relax like a native doctor. My friend, you need hands to be laid on you so that you can begin to learn to speak. Load yourself with scriptures. Load yourself with scriptures. Load yourself with revelations. And every time conditions show up, speak the word. There's a growth in your body, speak the word. There's sickness in your flesh, speak the word. Your teeth are not working, speak the word. Your wardrobe is dry, speak the word. Your kitchen is empty, speak the word. Anything mocking you, curse them in the word of God. From the word of God, speak the word. That is what gives you access. We gain access by words. Number two, we gain access by spilling blood. Because in the realm of the spirit, there's a place where words can reach. Only blood speaks in that region. Only blood speaks in that region. That means the most dangerous native doctor is the native doctor that play with blood. That play with blood. No matter what you do, Islam will never die. Because it's enshrined in blood. In Salah, we they kill rams. Are you following what I'm saying here? The Kirams. We also, we drink blood as Holy Communion. The most dangerous religion is the one that holds blood. They are powerful and they are strong on earth. That's why you don't avoid Holy Communion. You take them because you are empowered for spirituality and superiority over the battles of natural forces. But blood won't find expression until there is a platform called sacrifice. It's on the sacrifice of men that blood moves. Because you see, let me tell you some strong things. The church in Nigeria is prospering in a very strong way. Because at one point, the last 15, 20 years, we were sacrificing like fire. Now we are the most prosperous entity in the nation. Our economy is bad, everything. The leaders are thieves, they are witches, they are wicked. Only the church now that is the hope of the masses in my nation. But we did, many years ago, they call us rats. They call us, they laugh at us. But today we are loaded. We are turning bush to cities. The 20 largest churches in the world are in Nigeria. And we are taking the nation, we are taking the gospel back to the nations of the earth. Spilling blood. I've been to India 8 times. There's a massive revival. I'm on my way to Pakistan. Revival. There's a revival in China. The word of God is taking its preeminence. But it is thrives on sacrifice. I am solemnly sponsoring the Pakistan's crusade of $57,000. Sacrifice. I'm a preacher, but I'm sacrificing. Sacrificing. Sacrificing to ride. That's why if you touch me, you will die like a lizard. Because my life is a sacrifice. I'm not just a preacher. I'm a dangerous giver.
This year alone, I have sacrificed to only men of God over 68 million on consistent sacrifice, consistent lifestyle of sacrifice. So anytime you do major sacrifice, like men of God coming your way, like some this program being organized, you just say, Pastor, where is the budget? You go out your way, not out of convenience. Because anything you do for God out of convenience have no blessing. You must go out your way. It is not what you give that matters. It's what remains after you give that determines ultimately the outcome of your life. You are in a strange land and you are a child of God and you are holding back. You can't go forward in the midst of this dark cloud that covers this nation. All you need is a major realm of prophesying, speaking the word, and sacrificing. We began to give in Nigeria until people call us stupid and idiot. But now, multi-billionaires and millionaires have risen in the church. We are building cities. We are building things for God. Universities, running them like primary school. Massa, mega, mega things. In Dubai, you see sheikhs having aircrafts. In Nigeria, it's a normal thing for pastors. Because of the power of great sacrifice that we are engaging for our life to change. Hear me and hear me well. The gospel of telling you not to sacrifice is fighting your tomorrow. Bible says, remove not the ancient landmark which your father walked on. I am not afraid to talk about this because I am first a sacrifice to my generation. Nobody that knows Joshua Talina that does not know I'm giving to sacrifice. I own a personal television station. It's been running now for a long time, 24 hours, Shepherd's Touch TV. I am a sole sponsor of it. A sole sponsor of it. Every month I pay 6 million. And that is over, 6 million is almost $20,000 every month. And I pay nothing less than $15,000 every month on that TV station, minus other 24 television stations. And my life is a wonder. People die like lizards when they fight me. When there's no hope, doors open, bam, 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 gates. People have given me over 250 cars I didn't buy. They will be under pressures they give. And they begin to honor God. Hear me and hear me well. Politicians in my nations understand spiritual atmosphere. And they don't joke. Even the sheikhs you have here, they don't joke with spirituality. I will never forget, I was in Jumeirah Beach 7 years ago to eat. I just turned to one of the sheikh and I prophesied on him and told him what he had and I told him what happened yesterday, how his other wife was sick. He has brought me another 5 sheikhs. I prophesied on them one by one, one by one, one by one, and they were bringing more people because you could see that they also want to know their future and the way forward for their lives. One of them tell me, say, if you heal my wife of cancer, anything you want, I will give it to you. That is the level which these people are also desperate for spirituality. You must be an answer to your generation. Don't joke with your giving life. Not because I want to ask you to give, but make it a lifestyle. If you must have access, make it giving your lifestyle. Because in giving you sacrifice, in sacrificing you spill blood. Because you see, your blood is a process of overworked sweat. When you overwork your sweat, when your blood is overworked, it turns to sweat. And they give you in form of cash. So anytime money lay on God's altar, God does not see your money. He sees your sweat. He sees your blood. When your blood and the blood of Christ react and meet on the altar, there is a visible reaction for greater manifestation. Open your hands. I prophesy to somebody here. Whatever you are looking for shall begin to look for you. So learn to speak. Learn to speak the word of God. And learn to give. Even when it is not convenient. Learn to do it. And giving must not be for convenience. Giving must be something you go out your way consistently. Sometimes I ask pastor, what is the rent of this place? Pay in a month. Say, I pay for 1 month. I pay for 2 months. Don't wait for monies to be raised. Just be a partner with God in his kingdom. In your small way, in his kingdom. When God sees your heart and see your speakings, he will give you access to him. Of what use for God to bless you and you're not useful to his kingdom? So God is not a waster. He must see a heart. Gone are the days that if I serve God, I suffer, my friend. Not the God I know. Not the God we have taught in Nigeria. That people have risen. The present chief of defense staff, I prophesied on him to be. And when I prophesied, they posted him to a place where nothing is working. I called him, I said, chief, spill blood on God's altar and see me. I didn't tell him what to do. He went and did it himself and spilled the blood. He wrote it in 6 years. I laid hands on him, prophesied on Sunday. On Wednesday, Buhari made him chief of defense staff. And I prophesied, I said, I saw 4-star. He was a 2-star general. Now he's a 4-star general. He's one of the people that sponsored the Pakistan's crusade. Very deadly and committed man. As I'm telling you, he's a chief of defense staff for 5 years now. They cannot uproot him. The longest serving chief of defense staff in the history of Nigeria. And that man understands spiritual training. Every time he calls for me to speak, even yesterday, I spoke on him heavily in the morning. Because I saw where Buhari wanted to change government. So I commanded his hand to be stilled until this man, Kai, if you don't know how to do it, you won't go far. But hear me, God showed me opportunities in this land. And he said, the next 1 year, Dubai's wealth is about to increase 1,000 times. That is to say, money will enter and pass people's hand 1,000 times. Open your hand and prophesy the kind of breakthroughs you have never seen since you were born. Since you came to this land, I command it release upon you. I say, I command you release upon you. I say, I command you release upon you. I command you release upon you. God says the Lord, I'm giving you a growth. He said, I will reward you for your sacrifice in my kingdom. I will reward you, says the Lord. I saw you running multiple services. I saw this work explode. I will enter here 3 times. And the 3rd time, you won't explain what is happening to this work. I see an explosion. I see a breaking forth. I see expanding of your cocoons. And I heard the Lord said, I'm going to make millionaires out of here. He said, I will bless them because of you. He said, I'm seeing some hearts, says the Lord, who have been saying, Lord, if for anything else, bless me for your kingdom. And I heard the Lord speak to my right ear that I have heard your prayer. I will connect you to men of pedigree, men of affluence. I'll connect you to people of this land. They will open their heart towards you. They will favor you in a way you have never seen. He said, I will turn their heart in your favor. And I will command this land to respond to you. Say as the Spirit of the Lord. Lift up your hand, shall I receive? Know who I'm talking to, but you will never remain the same. I see angels all over this building. Oh my God, what is this? What is this? Look at angels. I see them with horn, and the horn is full of oil. And I ask, why are they here? He said, to raise men and women. Some of you, from the next 2 minutes from now, your body will start shaking, your hand will start shaking, your body will start vibrating. Some of you will start running, some of you will start shouting. Something is happening to you. Lift up your hands all over this building, all over this building. Shout access 7 times. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Stand on your feet, stand on your feet, stand on your feet. Everybody stand up. Lift up your hands, say, my father, I receive power, I receive fire, I receive power, I receive fire, I receive power, I receive fire, I receive power, I receive fire. For access, for access, for access. Oh my God, look at that, look at that, look at that, look at that. Target. Help him. Something is happening. Close your eyes. Receive it. Oh my God. Young men and young women, the anointing is on you. The fire. Their bodies are shaking. Lift up your hand. Close your eyes. Don't open your eyes. Receive your own. Oh my God. Receive. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. I saw this angel run to me and remove my clothes and he put it on 17 people. Yes. Lift up your hand, close your eyes. The anointing on my life is coming on 17 people. At the count of 5, they will start running, they will start jumping, they will start shouting. Oh my God, look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4. Receive it.
Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Oh my God, the fire. The fire. The fire. The fire. The fire.
Yes, yes.
Some people behind.
Yes.
Receive your own right now. Something is happening.
Yes, yes.
The glory. The glory.
Yes.
The glory. The glory.
Yes, yes.
The fire. The fire.
Fire. Fire. Fire.
Anybody on the floor, bring them to the front. Anybody on the floor, bring them to the front. Oh my God, take them to the front. Those of you behind, lift up your hands. Shout, I receive. I receive. Oh my God. 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 Oh my God, lift up your hands. Those of you behind, Holy Ghost, raise your millionaires among them. Raise them now. Anointing for money is falling on people. It's falling on people. Receive it.
Yes,
at the count of three. Those of you behind, at the count of three. One, two, three.
Packets. Packets.
Packets. Receive it. Bring that to the front. Pepper. Help him. Packets. Help him. Bring that to the front. Something is happening. Oh God, packets. Take the fire. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Take them to the front. Take them to the front. Something is happening. I see the Holy Ghost walking to the last row.
Yes.
Receive it. Packets.
Yes.
Receive it. Receive it.
Receive it.
Packets.
Yes.
Receive it. Receive it.
Yes.
Receive it. Packets. Packets. Somebody shout, I receive.
I receive.
Take them to the front. Lift up your hands. I see anointing for marriage. I see wedding ring in the hand of 32 people. 12 young men. 12 young men. Anointed to marry. Falling on ladies.
Yes, yes.
A young man.
Yes.
They cannot stand.
Yes.
Take it now.
Take
it now. Take it now. Take it now. Take it now. Take it now. Take it now. Take it now. Take it now.
Receive it.
Receive it. Receive it.
Receive it.
Receive it.
Receive it.
Receive it. Anointed for marriage. Lift up your hands. I see access for business.
Yes.
I see God giving people new businesses.
Yes.
There are about 42 of them.
Yes.
Anointed to make money.
Yes.
Anointed for business.
Yes.
It's coming upon them.
Yes.
Their body will start shaking.
Yes.
Their hands will start shaking.
Yes.
Oh my God, look at that.
Packets.
Packets.
Packets. I receive it.
Packets.
I receive it.
Packets.
I receive it.
Packets.
I receive it.
Packets.
I receive it.
Packets.
I receive it. Yes. 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 Yes.
Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Oh my God, everybody raise your hand. Raise your hands, raise your hands, raise your hand. Oh my God, I heard the Holy Ghost said, people will start preaching. Anointed to be a preacher. Anointed to be a pastor. There are three pastors, your anointing will increase. There are two ladies anointed to preach. He's upon them, he's upon them, he's upon them, he's upon them.
Yes,
oh
yes,
my
yes.
God,
yes.
Daggots!
Yes!
Daggots!
Break every chain.
Yes.
Break every chain.
Yes.
Break every chain. Break every chain.
Break every chain. Break every chain.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There is power
in the name of Jesus.
There is fire in the name of Jesus.
Oh,
break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Stretch your hand towards me as you receive. Stretch your hand as you want. All of you in front, stand up. All of you lying down, stand up.
Spirit.
Take it. Take it. others.
There's power in the name of Jesus.